Is capitalism a sin?
Yes. Capitalism, for me, and for many of us, at this present moment, is an evil. It's contrary to all that's good. It's contrary to the common good. It's contrary to compassion. It's contrary to all of the major religions. Capitalism is precisely what the holy books, our holy books in particular, remind us is unjust. And in some form and fashion, God will come down and eradicate somehow.
This was Father Dick Preston, the priest from Flint who married my wife and me.
Capitalism is wrong and therefore has to be eliminated.
Eliminated? That might be a little harsh. So I decided to go and talk to the priest that married my sister and brother-in-law. I'm sure he would have a more balanced approach when it came to capitalism.
It is immoral, it is obscene, it is outrageous, you know. It is really radical evil. It's radically evil.
Wow, does their boss know that they're talking like this? I thought it best to go and check this out with a bishop.
The system doesn't seem to be providing for the well-being of all the people. And that's what makes it, and it's almost in its very nature, something contrary to the Jesus who said, "Blessed are the poor, woe to the rich." That's right out of St. Luke's Gospel.
How have we put up with this system for so long? I mean,
the system has built into it what we call propaganda. I'm in awe of propaganda. The ability to convince people who are victimized by the very system to support the system and see it as a good.
We know that American capitalism is morally right because its chief elements, private ownership, the profit motive, and the competitive market are wholesome and good. They are compatible with God's laws and the teachings of the Bible.
For as long as I can remember, I've been told that competition and profit are good things.
They are compatible with God's laws and the teachings of the Bible.
And if increasing profits means locking up a few kids or cashing in on the death of an employee,
compatible with God's laws and the teachings of the Bible,
it is morally right to provide for the stockholders.
They are compatible with God's laws and the teachings of the Bible.
Debt, eviction, and exploitation.
God's laws and the teachings of the Bible.
What were we really pledging our allegiance to?
The profit motive.
And so all good Americans came to act as if they believed our capitalist economic system was compatible with the teachings of the Bible. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a priest. It wasn't because of the fancy get-ups or the Knights of Columbus escorts, or even the groovy nuns who were so good to me. It was because of the priests who went on the march from Selma, or tried to stop the war, or devoted their lives to the poor. They told me quite clearly what Jesus said, that the first shall be last, and the last shall be first, that the rich man will have a very hard time getting into heaven, that we will be judged by how we treat the least among us, and that there are no people more important to God than the poor. Since that time, it seems that Jesus got hijacked by a lot of people who believe that the Son of God was sent here to create heaven on earth for the well-to-do. I must have missed that part of the Bible where Jesus became a capitalist.
Please tell me, Master, what must I do to have eternal life?
Go forth and maximize profits.
You say the kingdom of heaven is at hand, but when exactly will it come?
When you deregulate the banking industry.
Help me. I've been this way for 20 years.
I'm sorry. I cannot heal your pre-existing condition.
He'll have to pay out of pocket.
Somehow I don't think Jesus came to earth so he could ring the bell at the New York Stock Exchange. And yet, from the very beginning, the rich have claimed him for their own.
When I'm on Wall Street and I realize that that's the very nerve center of American capitalism, and I realize what capitalism has done for working people in America, to me, that's a holy place.
Let me add to it. Over the whole duration of the Iraq War and the terror war, you look at the world stock markets and you look at the world economy, and despite these horrible pockets of unrest and killing and murdering that we've been describing, it's never been better. The global economy has never been better, and the global stock markets have never been better. Jimmy, it is either a God-given miracle, or it has something to do with the victories of the spreading world of capitalism, or both.
They think Wall Street's a holy place. What do you think Jesus would think of capitalism?
I think he would simply refuse to be part of it.